session on tax and revenue management. Okay, so basically tax and revenue management, we have a solution in SAP to manage all the government taxes and levy collections. So TRM is basically a solution for all the taxes by taxpayer and collections by collections taxpayer and tax officer. So this all depends on the three processes, basically 3 R's are registration, return and refund. So these help these processes helps taxpayer to give details overall 360 view of taxpayer liabilities. So how it can be 360? Okay, let me tell you. There are two form-based tax. There are two processes. First is form-based taxes, and second one is object-based taxes. So form-based taxes are for which the taxpayer has to submit a tax return. For example, we have income tax. So it is like a self-declaration by the taxpayer. Tax declaration are processed automatically. Exceptions are those which are handled by tax officer, like they are handling via tax officer work center. So in case if tax officer are paying on behalf of tax taxpayer, so it will not come under form-based taxes. The second one we have is object-based taxes. So object-based taxes are those taxes that are levied on assessment objects such as property or vehicle. Like these kind of taxes we have are object-based. And various business rules are configurable under VRF Plus for validation and calculation. We are setting up, we all are setting rules on VRF Plus only. Earlier it was BRF, now we are having VRF Plus. So let's proceed further. So basically this is an overview of a solution we have, that is TRM. So here we have 3 R's as I have mentioned earlier. So in this, registration can be done by taxpayer and by tax officer as well. So how taxpayer can register themselves? They can register through portal. We have a portal here where he can file return, he can see his payment, e-payment, he can see his account information, he can see his over activities, when it is doing, when it's going to be due, when ICR going to be due, everything he can see in portal. He will not be able to access SAP. So for front end we have a portal, and if we want to register or file return or get refund, there we have tax officer for that. Tax officer will have access of SAP ERP. They can go for portal also, and they can opt for SAP also. So through SAP system they can do registration, return, refund, repayment, everything here. So for payment and repayment we have different process, that is public sector collection and disbursement, that is PSAD. And for maintaining transparency and clarity we have SAP CRM for queries related to taxpayers, for auditing, everything we have related, it will cover in SAP CRM. So let's go further. So these are the basic elements, main elements of TRM, that is BP, that is business partner, CO, contract object, CA, contract account, FACTS and ICRs. These are the base of a TRM. So let's go further. To start with the master data elements, we have first with business partner. So what is business partner? Business partner is the taxpayer only, but business partner is registered with a unique identification number. So for every taxpayer it is compulsory to have a BP, that is business partner. So when you go for registration, suppose let's take an example, if taxpayer is registering himself through portal, as I mentioned earlier, he will have access of portal. So in portal he is registering himself, so he has to provide every details, like what is he, natural person, organization or group, what he is. So after mentioning that, he needs to enter details of his address, postal code, and how he wants to file his return. It's gonna be monthly, it's gonna be annually, it's gonna be quarterly. He has to mention each and every details in the registration form. So after registering this, he will the master data will get created, that is BP, CA and CO. The identification number will get created in BP, contact account will be created and CO will be created. Okay, let me explain you what are three basic elements, then we can further explain how it can be created through SAP system. So currently we are talking about how we can create master data in portal. So after entering details of BP, we have contact account. So contact account is basically describing a text type. What is the text type? Is we have different text type and revenue type for each text bill. It's gonna be VAT, sales tax. It depends from client to client which country having which text type. Like for India, we don't have VAT, but for UK we have a VAT. So it's gonna be different for each country. Let's go further. Contract object. Contract object represents the taxable object which contains all of the detail information and attributes for billing. Okay, let me tell you what is it. It is about like how you are entering details, like what is the date, what it's gonna be like you have to enter details of when it's going to be due. If business partner owns a property or vehicle, what is the object for it? So you need to mention the object of a taxpayer. So in contract object will represent tax object type. For example, if business partner owns a property and vehicle tax, then two contract account will be assigned, and for one property, one is for property and one is for vehicle. Then there will be two contract objects, that is one is for vehicle and one is for property. So like this is the master data structure, how it's gonna be interlinked. I'll tell you. So first is business partner. Business partners can have multiple contract account, like it's mentioned here, corporate income tax, VAT, service tax, sales tax, whatever it is. And in that, what is the object for it? It's gonna be location wise, it's gonna be plant wise, it's gonna be property tax. It will be divided as an object. So these are three main elements which will be created after you register themselves, after you register in portal. Or if you go by a SAP system, then the T code is for BP. BP means business partner. You have T code FPP1. For contract account, you can create through SCAA1. And in contract account, you have to link contract account and contract object will automatically link when you mention BP in it. So and contract object T code is piece of work. PSOBWORK. It is piece of work. This is how you can create an SAP system as well. Mind you, SAP system only tax officer can have that access, and tax officer can get details through form bundle. So form bundle is nothing but an collection of forms in which have details of a taxpayer. Taxpayer will fill the form and give it to the tax officer, so that tax officer can fill registration for a taxpayer, and then the process, then master data will get created. So let's go to the other two elements, that is facts and ICR. So facts structure consists of three things: fact category, fact type and fact set. It's a collection of time-dependent attributes which are required for tax calculation or administration. So how you will, this is a whole scenario of a calculation, how a taxpayer wants to calculate his tax. So first is fact category. So fact category is like plant, in plant what you have, category, size, employers, different categories we have. In there is one more location. In location we have street, town, employers, etc. So then it will consist of three things: category, size, employers. From street, it will go to types. Fact types are address, employee. Then this all will come into sets. It will be fact sets. So we can conclude this. There are two sets. We can conclude from whole situation. There are one set is plant and second set is location. And this will come under contract object. As I have mentioned earlier, like we need to define the object. What is the object of it? Like if it is a property, so here it comes, it will relate to it. So fact and ICR will come under contract object. Okay, let's go further. What is ICR? So ICR is the function to determine the due date. So we have already mentioned the time frame in facts. Through facts, ICR will fetch the due date through facts. So ICR is, it is the function to determine the due date by which a business partner is obliged to submit a declaration. So as we are talking about self-declaration, since it's a form-based, so it will be when it is going to be due. When we are having a dunning process, so it will all come under ICR, that is inbound correspondence request. So this is how you can declare your self-assessment. You can keep an eye on it. Thank you.